Hi everyone, in this video we'll learn how to perform data treatment using SAS Enterprise Miner. Specifically, we'll learn how to replace values in the data and how to handle missing values. Note that SAS Enterprise Miner is not designed specifically for data treatment, so it is not very user-friendly for data treatment as SPSS. This is done on purpose to reduce the size of the software. SAS has another tool, SAS Enterprise Guide, which is very similar to SPSS and can do a better job in data treatment. So I strongly recommend to treat data well before using SAS Enterprise Miner. Nonetheless, I want to show you how to do some basic data treatment with SAS Enterprise Miner. First, let's look at the data source again. Select data source, right-click and select explore. We'll examine sample statistics. The first variable I want to look at is net income. And we can notice that this variable has a minimum value of 0. This does not make much sense since 0 does not mean no income, given that participants attend the charity event. So it is most likely that zeros imply missing values. Let's take a closer look at this variable. In sample properties, we change fetch size from default to max and click apply. Then we'll create a histogram for this variable. Click plot and then select histogram. Then we select net income variable and change the row to x. Then click finish. This is the histogram. Right click, select graph properties and select show missing bin and change the number of X bins to 30. In this diagram, we can see the distribution of income. On the far left, we notice a large number of zeros, 2,358. These imply missing values. However, SAS Enterprise Miner treats zero as zeros, not as missing values. In SAS Enterprise Miner, a period means missing values. So we have to change all zeros of this variable to period. To do that, we use replacement node. Under modify tab, select and drag replacement node to the diagram, and then connect this node to the data source node. Select the replacement node. In the properties panel, scroll down to view the train properties. For interval variables, click on the value of default limits method and select none from the drop down menu that appears. This selection indicates that no values of interval variables should be replaced. With the default selection, a particular range for values of each interval variable should have been enforced. Then in the score properties, for replacement value, we change it from computed to missing. This is to treat the missing values. Scroll up to the train properties. For replacement editor, we click the three dot button. This is the list of variables. For net income variable, under limit method, we change it from default to user specify. Then we change the replacement lower limit to 1. This means any value below 1, meaning zeros, is considered missing value. Click OK. Then we right click at the replacement node and select run. The run is complete. We select results. In this window, under total replacement counts, we see the variable net income. And under interval variables, we see the replacing method is missing, meaning missing values. What SAS Enterprise Miner did was that it created a new variable. To see this new variable, we go back to the diagram and select replacement node. On the properties panel, in the general group, we select export data. In the next window, we select train and click explore. We'll look at the actual data. If we scroll all the way to the right, we see a new variable named rep net income. We click on the arrow to sort the data. This is the data sorted in an ascending order. We can notice that all zeros are replaced by periods, which imply missing values. That is how we replace values in SAS Enterprise Miner. The next data treatment is to impute missing values. Note that for non-parametric techniques such as decision tree, missing values are not problematic. However, for parametric techniques such as regressions or neural network, cases with missing values may be ignored, which decreases the amount of data and affects the predictive power. Under Modify tab, we select Impute and drag it to the diagram and connect it to the replacement node. Select the Impute node. On the Properties panel, scroll down to view the train properties. For interval variables, click on the value of default input method and make sure min method is selected. That means we replace missing values with the min values. For class variables, click on the value of default input method and keep count from the drop-down menu that appears. That means missing values will be replaced by the most frequent level. Basically, we keep these default settings. In the score group, for indicator variables, we change type from none to unique and change row from rejected to input. Now select Impute, right-click, select Run, and click Yes. The run is complete. Select Results. Here's our results. Under Imputation Summary, you can see that three variables have missing values. Age, gift average card last 36 months, and replace median income. They are all interval variables, and the imputation method is mean, and the impute values that was used. New variables with imputed missing values have IMP at the beginning. These variables should be used for analysis. That is how to treat data using SAS Enterprise Miner. Thank you, and bye now.